Good morning students, welcome back to today's online class. So students, last week you have learned about the new topic environmental science. So in that chapter you have learned about biogeochemical cycle. So first we can recall whatever you have learned in the last class. So what is biogeochemical cycle? The cyclic flow of nutrients between the living and non-living organisms are called biogeochemical cycle. So under that biogeochemical cycle, it can be classified into three types. They are water cycle, nitrogen cycle, third one is carbon cycle. So biogeochemical cycle can be classified into three types. They are water cycle, nitrogen cycle, carbon cycle. Last class you have learned about water cycle. Water cycle, it is otherwise called hydrological cycle. The processes involved in water cycles are evaporation, transpiration, sublimation, condensation, precipitation, surface runoff, infiltration and percolation. So what are the processes involved in water cycle? The processes involved in water cycle are evaporation, sublimation, transpiration, condensation, precipitation, runoff, infiltration and percolation. So water cycle we have learned in the last class. Today we are going to learn about nitrogen cycle. So nitrogen, see, nitrogen, it is an essential component for all living organisms. So for the growth of the plant, nitrogen is very, very essential. And also all the living organisms, nitrogen is very, very important. So where it is present? Nitrogen, it is present in the atmosphere in the form of gaseous state. So nitrogen, it is present in the atmosphere in the form of gaseous state. There are about 78% of nitrogen, it is present in the atmosphere. 78% of nitrogen, it is present in the atmosphere. See, it is an essential component of protein, nucleic acid and chlorophyll. It is an essential component of protein, nitric acid and chlorophyll. So there are 78% of nitrogen, it is present in the atmosphere, it is in the form of gaseous state. So it is very, very important for all the living organism. The plants take nitrogen for their growth. For the growth of the plants, it is, the nitrogen is very, very essential. The process involved in nitrogen cycles are, first one is processes, water cycle we have learned many processes, don't confuse. The process involved in nitrogen cycle are nitrogen fixation, second one is nitrogen assimilation, third one is ammonification, fourth one is nitrification, fifth one is denitrification. So the processes involved in nitrogen cycle are nitrogen fixation, nitrogen assimilation, ammonification, nitrification and denitrification. The first one is nitrogen fixation. Already we learned the nitrogen, it is present in the atmosphere in the form of gaseous state. So the plants cannot absorb the nitrogen in the nitrogen as such. See, it should be converted into nitrate or nitrite or ammonia acid, ammonic acid. So nitrogen, it is present in the atmosphere in the form of gaseous state. The plant cannot absorb directly the nitrogen, but the nitrogen should be converted into nitrate ion or nitrites or ammonic acid. What is nitrogen fixation means? See, the atmospheric nitrogen can be fixed in the soil by using the microorganism. So the nitrogen, it should be fixed in the soil. So here there's some microorganism involved to fix the nitrogen in the soil. That is the soil bacteria such as Acetobacter and the blue-green algae. Cyanobacteria, and the leguminous plants consist of, in the roots, it consists of nitrogen fixing bacteria that is called rhizobium. So these microorganisms, they can fix the nitrogen, atmospheric nitrogen, to the soil. So the nitrogen, it is in the form of gaseous state in the atmosphere. Directly the plant cannot absorb the nitrogen, so it should be fixed in the soil. It should be fixed in the soil by the microorganisms such as soil bacteria such as Acetobacter, blue-green algae that is cyanobacteria, and rhizobium. So these are the microorganisms involved in nitrogen fixation. So they can fix the nitrogen to the soil. So the leguminous plants such as pea, beans, etc., it contains the nitrogen fixing bacteria rhizobium. It is colonized in the root and it forms the root nodules. These bacteria, they can fix the atmospheric nitrogen to the soil. Next one is nitrogen assimilation. What is nitrogen assimilation means? So the plant absorb the nitrate ions nitrate ion, and it should be converted into proteins and nucleic acid inside the plant body. So the plant absorb the nitrate ion from the soil and it should be converted into the organic matter such as proteins and nucleic acid. So in the plant body, the protein is present. That protein is called plant protein, and then from the plant it can be transferred to the animal body. We all know the plant absorb the nitrate ion and it should be converted into proteins and nucleic acid. Now the protein present in the plant body is called plant protein. It should be transferred to the animals. So we all know the herbivores, they can consume the plants. So they can depend upon plants for their food. They are consuming the plants. While consuming the plants, the plant protein, now it is entered into the herbivores. So now it is entered into the animals. It is called animal protein. So next, the carnivores. The carnivores, they can synthesize the protein from their food. So likewise, the protein can be transferred from the plants to animals. So when the protein present in the plant body, it is called plant protein. When it is entered into the animal body, it is called animal protein. So in nitrogen assimilation, the plant absorb the nitrate ion and it should be used them for organic matter such as protein and nucleic acid. The plant protein, it can be transferred to the herbivores, and now it is called animal protein. The herbivores can be eaten by the carnivores. So the carnivores, they are synthesizing the protein from their food. So that is called nitrogen assimilation. Here no microorganism involved. Next one, ammonification. So next one is ammonification. So what is ammonification means? The process of decomposition of protein. Decomposition of protein by using the microorganisms such as putrefying bacteria. So the process of decomposition of nitrogenous waste by putrefying bacteria, that process is called ammonification. So in the animal body, say the protein is present, the protein, it can be the excreted in the form of urea, uric acid or ammonia. So the nitrogenous waste can be excreted from the animals in the form of urea, uric acid or ammonia. See, now this nitrogenous waste can be decomposed by the putrefying bacteria and fungi. Bacteria and fungi, and it can be converted into ammonia compounds. So the nitrogenous waste can be decomposed by putrefying bacteria and fungi, and it can become converted into ammonia. So in the ammonification process, ammonia is prepared. Next one is nitrification. What is nitrification means? See, in this process, the ammonia compounds, that is during the process of ammonification, ammonia is produced. During nitrification, the ammonia that is formed during ammonification, it can be oxidized by the microorganism, with the help of the microorganism such as the nitrifying bacteria, such as Nitrosomonas, such as Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter. With the help of this microorganism, say the ammonia that can be produced during ammonification, it can be get oxidized and form nitrate ions. Soluble nitrate ions are produced. So during nitrification, so with the help of nitrifying bacteria such as Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter, say the ammonia that can be converted into soluble nitrate ions. So the ammonia get oxidized and form soluble nitrate ion. That process is called nitrification. Then the next process, denitrification. So what is denitrification means? Say the soil bacteria such as Pseudomonas species. Pseudomonas species. These Pseudomonas species, they can be reduce the nitrate ions into gaseous nitrogen. So the soil bacteria such as Pseudomonas species, they can reduce the nitrate ions into gaseous nitrogen. Again, this gaseous nitrogen, it can be sent to the atmosphere. Again, this process is taken place. The cycle. So here the one cycle is formed, that is called nitrogen cycle. So the processes involved in nitrogen cycle are nitrogen fixation, nitrogen assimilation, ammonification, nitrification, and denitrification. So in nitrogen fixation, the atmospheric nitrogen that can be fixed to the soil with the help of Acetobacter, blue-green algae and rhizobium. Rhizobium, it is a nitrogen fixing bacteria that is present in the leguminous plant, root of the leguminous plant. They can fix the atmospheric nitrogen to the soil. Next one, nitrogen assimilation. The plants absorb the nitrate ions and it can be converted into the organic molecules such as proteins and nucleic acid. See, this plant protein, it can be transferred to the herbivores and it is called animal protein, and from herbivores it can be transferred to the carnivores. So the carnivores, they are synthesizing the proteins from the food they absorb. So by this way, the plant protein can be transferred to the animal protein. So due to decomposition after the death of the plant as well as the death of the animals, it can be decomposed and form the protein. So next one, ammonification. Ammonification, here the microorganism involved is putrefying bacteria. So the during ammonification, it can decompose the nitrogenous waste. The putrefying bacteria decomposes the nitrogenous waste and it can be converted into ammonia compounds. So next one is nitrification. So ammonia compounds that can be prepared during the process of ammonification, it can be get oxidized by nitrifying bacteria such as Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter. It can be converted into soluble nitrate ions. Then denitrification. During denitrification, the microorganism involved, that is Pseudomonas species, this can be involved in denitrification. The nitrate ions get reduced and form gaseous nitrogen. Again, it can be sent to the atmosphere. See, this process is called nitrogen cycle. Next one is human impact of nitrogen cycle. So the nitrogen cycle, it can be affected by humans. So how is the first one is human impact of nitrogen cycle. The first one is the burning of fossil fuel. It can affect the nitrogen cycle. The second one is the application of nitrogen based fertilizer to the soil, and it can be taken away by more amount of nitrogen based fertilizer, if it is applied to the soil, it can be taken away by the runoff water and it can be entered into the rivers, channel, lakes, ponds, etc. So it can affect the general habitat of the species, and also it can affect the biodiversity. That is the human impact of nitrogen cycle. So this nitrogen cycle is very, very important. That these microorganisms are in very, very important. During nitrogen fixation, the microorganism involved is Acetobacter, blue-green algae, cyanobacteria and rhizobium. And during ammonification, the microorganism involved is putrefying bacteria. During nitrification, the microorganism involved is nitrifying bacteria such as Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter. And during denitrification, the microorganism involved is Pseudomonas species. So today we have learned about the nitrogen cycle. So biogeo cycle consists of three, that is water cycle, nitrogen cycle, carbon cycle. Last class we have learned about water cycle. Today we learned nitrogen cycle. And next class we can learn about carbon cycle. So students, now you can mark the questions. Take your textbook. Page number 300. Choose the correct answer. First two questions, last class you have marked third one. The atmospheric carbon dioxide enters into the plants through the process of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. Then, second one, match the following. Roman letter 2, match the following microorganism role play. First one, Nitrosomonas. Nitrosomonas, the answer is nitrification. Nitrification. Second one, Acetobacter, nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen fixation. The third one, Pseudomonas species, denitrification. Pseudomonas species, denitrification. Putrefying bacteria, ammonification. Putrefying bacteria, ammonification. So first one, Nitrosomonas, nitrification. Acetobacter, nitrogen fixation. Pseudomonas species, denitrification. Putrefying bacteria, ammonification. Then, Roman letter 5, answer briefly. How do human activities affect nitrogen cycle? Second question. How do human activities affect nitrogen cycle? Page number 293. Second part, first para. Human impacts on nitrogen cycle. Burning fossil fuels, application of nitrogen based fertilizer, that paraphilia to general habitat. General habitat. Then, page number 292. 292. You can write the question. Describe the process involved in nitrogen fixation. Describe the processes involved in nitrogen cycle. Describe the processes involved in nitrogen cycle. Page number 292, nitrogen cycle, the second para. Processes involved in nitrogen cycle are nitrogen fixation, nitrogen assimilation, ammonification, nitrification, denitrification. Up to page number 293, up to denitrification. The gaseous nitrogen which enters the atmosphere, up to that. So, very, very important question, study well. So, today's home assignment is this question. Describe the processes involved in nitrogen cycle. So, next week you have the home test. So, the botany test portion is chapter 23. Okay, students, study well and write the exam test very well. Thank you, students.